These times of vision.
And first, when start the practice, you visualize the Buddha Dharma Sangha in front of you in the space. And you take the refuge in the Buddha Dharma Sangha. I take refuge in the Buddha. I take refuge in the Dharma. I take refuge in the Sangha. And then you repeat these three terms. And then also at the same terms, you generate, I'm going to generate the loving kindness compassions of the altruistic minds of the belief of sentient beings. When you generate the loving kindness compassion, the loving kindness compassion divided into three categories. The first one is generating compassion towards sentient beings. And directly focusing on the sufferings of sentient beings, that those who are going through physical and mental sufferings and all kind of generally as a human beings, each runs have sufferings. We are human runs, but we have general sufferings for everybody. Birth, all age, sickness and death, then according to each karma, we go through a very different variety of illness and sufferings. Therefore, you special minds generating that all these beings may be free. The next one is the generating the compassion through the Dharma practice. And when you talk about this, is that when you practice the Lord Buddha taught the Four Noble Truths, when you practice the Four Noble Truth, you realize the special things that cause and effect, where the sufferings come from. Sufferings come from the negative karma. Where the happiness come from. Happiness come from the positive karma. And then this negative karma should be abandoned. Positive should be developed and achieved in nirvana. And then when you realize that, then you have the sentient beings, that you have a compassion to the sentient beings, that those who now realize this.
And
this compassion, to practice this compassion to rise, you have to practice the Dharma to come to the realizations of this, and then you generate compassion. Other compassion is just people who are suffering, so we can easily generate. But we have to generate the compassion, those who are creating the negatives. For example, when somebody is creating a lot of negative karma, we don't have the compassion. He says, oh, this person should be suffer because he's doing such a bad things, these bad goals. But we don't have the compassion. When you practice Dharma, you realize that then you have compassion for this person because this person is blind, ignorance about cause and effect.
When
的申请，我们没有申请任何的慈悲心。当我们有这些正念以及有这些的慈悲心，我们不会以这样的观点去看待那一位的众生。
The next one is the compassion, like unfabricated compassion, is no aim, because we have the aim, like those who suffer, and also those who accumulate negatives, we have a compassion. But only we have a special compassion. The special compassion is when you achieve the realization of the interdependence.Of originals, or you achieve the realizations of the nature of the minds, the emptiness of the Mahamudra or Natamika, then you have a compassion that those people who did not realize, I have a compassion.
所谓的慈悲心，慈悲心是没有关注别人的对象的。我们的发展，我们的慈悲心不是有关注的一些，好像。我们的慈悲心不是对一个人，是对大众而言。
And all the phenomena, the internal phenomena and external phenomena are empty, inseparable of appearance and emptiness, and inseparable of clear light and emptiness.
外在和内在的显象的物质。外在的、内在的、显象的物质，全部都是空性的。所显现的东西，全部都是空性的。
Clear light and emptiness. Great bliss and emptiness.
显现也是无常的，也是空性的。
And this, when you sentient being do realize it.We think everything is independently their own rise, is solid, hold on to this reality, and then grasping, and that what that practitioner have compassion, I have compassion to these people, those who do not realize the suchness. When you meditate these such as feelings of this, then after you taking the refuge, Buddha Dhamma Sangha dissolve into life, and then dissolve into you, then that moment you meditate, receive the blessing from the Buddha Dhamma Sangha, and including all such things. And this is the preparation for being going to become a chundas. The next one is you say Om Sova Vashuta Swadharma means everything, your ordinary body, ordinary speech, ordinary mind, outside everything dissolve into emptiness.
在我们所看到的世俗的一些身口意，我们都要想象它化为空性。
And you must also not pretend as much as possible. You meditate on this that you get feelings of suchness of space. Space is everywhere. Without space, nothing can work. No, without space, we cannot move. Without space, cannot build. Without space, nothing. Therefore, but this suchness of space is important. And your mind and this space is same.
空性的这些空间呢，我们如果要去摸索，是本身找不到的，因为它是不处在不视线，我们而且用手是触摸不到的。
This space, such as a space called uncuttable, because you cannot cut through weapons, you cannot squeeze the sky, there's nothing can harm.And therefore, you are meditating, your mind is also such a sadness that experience when you meditate in that state. And it's indestructible. Nothing can destroy. is like a diamond. We can cut through other things, but nothing can cut through this. Therefore, that's why the space.
而且它又是不能毁坏的，有如一般的钻石，钻石是能毁坏外在的物质的一切，而它本身不能被毁坏的。
And also, it is progressive. Progressive means everything has a space. Space within the form is space. It is foundations of all. And then it is that suchness that your mind is similar.
所要看到那些空性的物质根本是摸索不到的，然而我们是要吸引我们的这些禅修慢慢的做，我们就会无形中慢慢发现到这些空性的内在的那些喜乐。
And that space, a deep space, you meditate. When you meditate in your actual own mind, now,start to rise in Mr. Chandrasik. Then from that blue, beautiful space, then the lotus flowers appear. It's like a sky. Your mind is like a sky. In the morning, sun comes out of the sky. Just like a little bit red, and then slowly comes, then the sun comes out, and then it has a ray light, and this has an energy, solar energy, similarity.
在我们的内心要升起一种所谓的一种空性的空间，然后在我们内心深处要生出一朵莲花，那些莲花的上面就是要所谓坐着的慈悲观音。
And then visualize the lotus flowers. On the lotus flowers, mundas. This is beautiful. When these are the train. If you don't train for generating, you have not success in completion state.Understand? We have to perfect the generating state. Completion state is emptiness. Going back to emptiness is more difficult.
在我们的所谓的观想的时候，我们观想有一朵的莲花在我们的内心当中。那莲花的上面是有一个白色的叶轮，那叶轮是代表的慈悲。
And from the mundas, visualize.Silver Shri. If you don't remember Shri, just visualize something that very essences appear on the mundas as your own, it's your primordial Buddha nature. They call it Tathagata Garbha. That appear as a Shri.
不但会观想这个睡的字的话，就自然想象中，在月轮的上面有一种的光，是我们自信佛性的。
And then the Shri start to light radiate. It is powerful because it's the very, very essence of everything. And that Shri's light radiate goes to all the Buddha people and make offering to the Buddhas and the Bodhisattvas. And then.The Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, light comes when the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas dissolve into the Shri. The Shri instead, they transform into Chandrasik. And
then, in the Shri of the Chandrasik, it will help the light of the Shri to transform all the Bodhisattva. And then, the Bodhisattva accepts the light of the Shri, it will help the light of the Shri to transform the Bodhisattva into the Bodhisattva.然后那些种子就会化现出另外一种的慈悲观音。
And as it becomes the one face, four arms, sitting in full lotus posture, white in color, Sambhogakaya Buddha, but also now the Chinese, Mahayana Chinese tradition, also two arms. Whatever your devotion goes, it is nature is same.Because these deities are many present millions. because according to each and every sentient's need. Therefore, whatever your devotion is today, is we're going to do four hours in that. The right hand is holding the mala, represents the continuity of benefiting sentient beings one after another, liberation to Buddha food. And the left upper hand is holding the lotus flowers. They represent that Chandrasik manifests many high lamas, reincarnated or monks, men, household, animals, whatever, in the samsara. The Chandrasik, even though reincarnated in the samsara, it doesn't default their mind, staying while the samsara falls. And then the joints in the heart, two arms, the joints in the heart is in the state of supplication to all the Buddhas and the Bodhisattvas to request to bless and liberate all sentient beings from the sufferings. And then you're holding the jewel inside is represent the bodhicitta. You must realize the ultimate bodhicitta in order to free from the samsara. And then also wearing the five crown is the Chandrasik is inseparable of five families of Buddha and also the inseparable of five
wisdom.
And then also the body radiating light is like a sunlight, it's like a going compassion light goes to all sentient beings. And in the heart, inside the Chandrasik, visualize the moon rays. On the moon rays, visualize the Shri. And then also there is Chandrasik is white, Shri is white, moon rays is white, but you eat white, but you can make a difference. Chandrasik is body is like crystal color, and the moon is moon color, Shri is like a pure color, then these colors are very clear. And then surrounded by Om Mani Padme Hum, multiple color. And when you start to chanting Om Mani Padme Hum, you energize your compassion, say the bodhicitta, and your wisdom, all three things together is mixed term, energized. Then that energized light is like a sunlight. When it goes out, all sentient beings reach this light, but not only light, with the blessings of love and compassion to liberate sentient beings. is like a solar light. The sun is very far, millions of miles away. But when they come to our hands, you see the invisible energy. You see the light not only clear the darkness, but you see it feel warm, but invisible, you cannot see. The similarity changes it. Send the light ray with this wisdom energy. And when you meditate, there each and every session be received and liberated.
那些无量的光影如毫如比如说是当我们在外面看到太阳这么远这么遥远但是它的光亮当我们在外面我们把所伸出来它还是会照亮在我们的手这么明亮就是要有这样的光的这么亮的感觉去观想这些众志所射出的那些光。那我们开始是不是
Yeah.